Evening, everybody, and welcome to another review here at Dom Limited. So, we have ourselves a laptop video for tonight, and I also received a solid-state drive on a donation for this video, so I want to thank the anonymous donor for it. He wished to remain anonymous, so I'm going to respect his wishes. So we will be using that in tonight's featured film. So this is the laptop that we are going to be working with tonight. This is a no bills laptop. An interesting story behind that is, let's make sure I got it. Interesting story behind it is, this came from a church, and this is a custom built laptop. This is made by the vendor. Let's see. With no bills, N4055. Which is my Equus computing. And this model is MS.16 GP. So, this is, when they got this set up back in the day, they kind of cut corners. Not the vendor themselves, but the person that bought this. They could have went with a i7 or an i5 Intel processor, but they decided to go with the Intel Pentium processor. This one has DDR3 memory, 8 gigs of RAM. And we will get some tools out momentarily. Let's see what we have here. One of my screwdrivers here. So, thanks to the moment of video editing, we'll get it. We're back. So, first things first, take the battery out. Put it over here. So this is the kind of battery that is in here. It is a 49 watt Model B BTY S14. You can get these on eBay very easily. So those shear bolts. Okay. And I do have the literature and paperwork for this computer. This was originally fitted for doing with for running Windows 7 Home Premium. Back in the day. Oh, I forgot a screw. Just pops right up like that. So this is month. This is from 20. This computer was built in 2013, and it was in service up until 2019. So it's paid for itself over time. Here we do have, there's an 8-gig module in the system already. That's crucial. That's an 8-gig. And I will be buying another module to put in. When you're putting memory modules in, you always want to make sure that you got them seated in there properly. Okay, so next we will take the hard drive caddy out. Bear with me here, well, that's awfully dumb, but the heat, okay, that was a little easier than I thought. So this is the hard drive, and actually this is not a bad hard drive, but due to a lot of confidentiality on there, I can't show you anything that's on this drive. So we will take the hard drive out of its caddy. So note to self, the glass screws are what goes in for the bezel and the cover, and these silver shorter screws are for the caddy. So we'll put these over here. And this just comes right off. And we'll save this hard drive, but I'll use it for something else. Sorry about that. So we will unbox this. Looks at that. Instructions.
back in the important thing is when you're putting in your caddies, you don't ever want to put the screws in backwards or strip them out, because once you do that, you're screwed. So put that back in there like that. Put that tab back down in there. And we will put back in. Nothing too fancy. 15.6 inch screen. It's LCD. It's got a horrible glossy screen on it. very primitive looking. Keyboard is decent. And trackpad's alright. So we'll go ahead and turn it on. Tell me I bricked it. Alright, I'll be right back in a few minutes. Alright, so what happened was I didn't have the memory module in proper position. So, there we go. This is what the BIOS looks like. So this is model MS-16 GP. So it shows that we have Lexar 128GB SSD. We'll go to system information. Currently shows the BIOS version. And that's an Intel Pentium R CPU. It's a 2020M clocked at 2.40 GHz. It's got EMT64 supported. It's got 2400 MHz processor stepping, 306 A9 microcode vision. Is 12, it's 2 cores. So down the road we'll get another memory module for this computer, make it a 16 gig PC eventually. So here you can change like your different clock speed, but we'll just keep it at. That's the change from SATA IDE. Intel speed step enabled. USB configuration. So we're just gonna leave that at. So here you can just change the boot orders. You can put a supervisor password, which we're not gonna do. So we're gonna. The boot CD in. But you have to wait and see what I install. Or slow this is gonna go. I'll tell you, this is not Windows, so we'll wait and see what happens. I don't know how long it's gonna take. Mm-hmm. to magic video editing. We can come back once we start making more progress.
Okay.
We're making more progress now. Only had to wait about a minute or two. So, as you see, we're installing Kubuntu. It's a Linux slider. Well, the problem with Windows 10 is it's very hard on computers. Especially these old computers, but the alternative Linux runs a lot easier. There's not as many processes running. And you don't have a lot of sneaky and underhanded stuff running either. So, bear with me while we get through this installation. I did practice ahead of time, but with a different drive. So, this is actually going a lot faster than it did on mechanical drive. Mechanical drive, it only took about 6 hours. So far, we started this around 10:30. So we'll just have to wait and see what how long this takes. We will be back momentarily. Sorry about that. We're back now, so that actually went a lot faster than I anticipated. So we'll go ahead and install Kubuntu. More English. See if this section, wireless driver actually works with Linux. Because with Windows 10, this thing did not work, period. So, fresh disk, so I'm not worried about wiping anything out. Chicago. Dirt buggy. Okay, so you got a password. Make this a functioning laptop once again. Not bad for being 8 years old. I'm so hungry. Oh, we should be done with this 12th. Progress. Installation complete. You can restart your computer. Newsroom with media. It's not a problem. That's not bad at all. And actually, it's fairly quiet. So that's a good thing. Sweet. Incomplete. Actually, no. Of course, I gotta get hooked up to a network. Maybe this won't work out as well as I thought. Alright, settings. Our system rather. Ubuntu, you have to manually enter all that information. Thank you. bear with me while we get this figured out.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back.
It's been a while since we've been on video, but I had to do some research on why the wireless card was not working on here, and my discovery that card malfunctioned. That's why the Wi-Fi doesn't quite work on there. So we're gonna have to buy a replacement. And we're gonna restart. Although this does have a good battery on here. But other than that, everything else is pretty much functionable on this PC. Except for the wireless. But we can fix that. We'll just buy a new chip. Shut down. Using a Sears Craftsman screwdriver. I think that one will fit the bill.
Nah, I don't wanna. Let's get the ones. I think this one will work just fine. This is a wireless. So that's the kind of chip that we are. That uses some of the Intel Centrino Wireless N2230 model. 2230B NH MW. So. I may even have one of these, so obviously this one went bad, and the CMOS battery is still good yet. Let's see if I still got that parts laptop. Okay, we're gonna have to look that part up online. And technically, I didn't pay anything for this computer, so. So we'll go online real quick and Google the parts. That's a lot of money. So Amazon. Well, it's only $8. That's not bad. We can afford that. So that's not too bad at all. Set to buy. It's crucial. this. It's not an exact match, but it'll do. 28. Well, that's not too bad. That's about $40. So, we can do that. I'll make this laptop more sellable. This off for reference. Give you a sneak peek of what's coming up on the channel. Take a look at that. You don't see those every day. So we'll get those parts ordered. and then we will finish up that video. Take care for now, and we'll see you soon.
Well, hello and welcome back to another video here at the Unlimited.
So, where we left off with this laptop was the wireless wasn't quite working properly, but turns out that chip isn't, there's nothing wrong with it. So I had a second one here, and it did the same thing that this one did on this computer. So what I'm gonna do is when I sell this one, I'm gonna put a wireless adapter on, and we'll go from there. I have a couple of them here that I can put with it. I'm gonna go out for sale. So that's what we're gonna do. So we're gonna go ahead and put it back together, because it doesn't do any good sitting. So just pop that back in. Grab a screwdriver. Okay, I'm kind of pushing my luck. We'll just use this set of screwdriver bits for this job. Thank you. actually this. First. jobs. I know. Since this is Kubuntu, I may or may not be able to get drivers for the USB adapter. Since it's going on the rummage, this is going to be some messes. As far as, we'll just hook up to the network real quick here. I will also include this mouse. This would make a spectacular web browser. It's got a solid state drive installed. It's actually a lot faster than
to it.
As you can see, it handles itself pretty well. Make sure to check for some updates. gonna work, but quite a bit of software, or open source software, that you can get. Thank you. See this one, but I need to make some clear up some computers that are no longer going to be using and stuff like that. So, thank you for watching, and we'll be back with another video very soon.